So I'm taking my shit, patting me down the street, taking my wallet, doing the ground, all of a sudden start patting on my dick and shit. And I was like, man, get the fuck off me, because I'm on the projects, I will fight this shit like that. But then, his second in command, I knew he was the second in command, because he the only motherfucker that had a leather skirt set on, and they had a ring. So he's like, let a motherfucking real nigga touch your dick.
Yo, 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 All Gas No Breaks Podcast, Super San Santi here. We got a special, special, special guest.
Yes, indeed.
Sir, can you please tell them where they can find you, all your plugs?
Oh, yeah, yeah. I'm Mr. Dark Comedy. I'm in the motherfucking building. Ain't that shit they can do about it. Mega Wolf of Comedy. Listen, you can find me on Instagram. You know, this is how relevant it is. I ain't going to my own home, but I'm going to get my flowers right now. You can put in MR on Instagram, Facebook, or YouTube, and I guarantee to be in the top five.
Just adding the M and R.
MR. And then if you push D,
don't I'm push the D, ladies.
Right now, you gonna try me? Why you wanna try me? Try me.
Yes. Don't push
Come
the
on,
D, ladies.
Come on, do it. Do it. Try me. Test me. Test me now. I'm going. What you going, Instagram? YouTube?
We got somebody doing it. We got somebody doing it.
Why you wanna try me?
Yes.
Try me.
Mr. Dark Comedy.
Mr. Dark Comedy.
Put the M, the capital M, the R.
Space, I'm assuming.
No, no space. No,
no space.
Space.
Oh, space.
Okay.
Dot D.
You gonna get, D, got this man pushing D. The D.
Capital D, too.
Capital D.
The big D.
I'm Mr. Darwin Comedy. That's right. That's true. It's somebody been talking about me.
Now, you... Boy, bye.
With the capital D.
With the capital D.
There you go.
Where can we find you at, Mrs. Over?
Mr.
Where can we find you at?
I'm Quanta Vol, and I'm on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat. I'm everywhere.
She is everywhere.
I'm everywhere.
And we got this young man to my far left.
Yes, yes. How you guys doing?
Yes, yes.
We're doing great. How you doing, brother?
Man, I'm feeling good.
How you digging the DMV so far?
DMV is good. It's different, real different from New York, but it's fire, I got to say.
Yeah.
He's fucking
with it. It is a beautiful place.
Yes, yes, yes. Where can we find you, brother?
You can find me on Instagram, YouTube, TikTok at VVITCHES.
Underscore.
Two underscores.
Yeah, okay. It's two.
I edit these motherfuckers. Yeah. I know that's two underscores. Like,
that's not all of it.
Yo, Mr. Dark Comedy, thank you for coming out. Yo, and hold on. Shout out to my boy Rex Corollas.
Hey,
shout out to my boy Rex Corollas, Block Party Entertainment.
The one and only.
I forgot the headphones today. He put this shit together.
Yeah, he put some shit together.
Quick. You see, he got the little skinny headphones. He got the skinny little headphones.
You're gonna make it work. Gonna make it work.
Such a fucking gentleman.
But can I tell you guys, those are new.
What?
He cracked them bitches right out the case.
Oh, I'm not surprised.
Okay.
I'm not surprised at all.
Well, brand fucking new, son. That shit shocked me. I was like, nigga, don't even make those no more.
I got them right here.
He's a hoarder.
The ultimate hoarder.
Yeah. You got these motherfuckers. You ain't find me yet, bro?
But
yo,
you know we don't know all that technology stuff.
You said I think I put it in wrong.
You got a cricket phone.
We in the basement, dog. He not on the Wi-Fi.
Huh?
He got the new 13. He got the new 13.
No, he ain't got the 13.
No, we do got the 13.
That's
no,
13? 12 and a half.
He got the Samsung.
I know I got
Jeremy.
The Pro Max 12.
Now, he got 12 the Samsung possible. Jeremy. He Android. He a droid. You know what? I ain't gonna lie. I rock both Droid and iPhone. I just do both.
I was Droid for a long time.
Yeah.
But I'm gonna tell you something.
Yeah.
Because of me, I'm so productive and I like to do stuff. And I need my phone to correspond with me.
Yeah.
I need an assistant without having to pay for it.
Right.
And
that makes
I can
sense.
Say I ain't gonna say it now, but I could call her and she's on demand. I could tell her looking for a spell something. Yeah. I was the other day, I was like, how to spell the fuck that?
That's some good shit.
How the fuck you spell that? And I was confused. But once I got this motherfucking iPhone now, I'm never confused.
So what'd you ask her? How you spell that?
Yes.
Hey Siri.
Yes.
You call it Siri still?
Yes, I did.
You didn't program another name? You just left it still Siri?
Yeah. Like, if I ask her, hey Siri, What's my name?
You're Sandy Artis, but you asked me to call you Mr. Dark Comedy.
Feel my arrogance. Feel my arrogance, man.
Tell him, Siri.
Oh, Lord.
Come on, I spilled some.
He got it. Okay, so have you seen that movie where the nigga fell in love with his cell phone app?
Her?
Her.
Did y'all see her?
Bro, no. That.
Hey, bro.
Did y'all see her?
Rex.
You haven't seen her?
Nah.
I'm going to tell you.
He fell in love with an app like the guy fell in love with his
phone. He fell in love with like an iPhone.
Wow.
Yeah, they were about to have
a serious relationship.
On Instagram, you top.
I'm number two on Instagram.
Oh, shit, we over here following.
Do Facebook.
Wu-Tang.
Ain't a good thing.
You don't got Facebook?
I did Facebook. I ain't seen
nothing. You ain't put Mr. Dark or nothing. Put MR.D, the big
D. MR.D. We still over here doing this,
oh
y'all.
Oh, my God.
Hey, look, while we doing that. Hey, look, while we doing that.
I was like, what the fuck?
We're going to have you shake it up and everything, and then pull something out. Pull out a question, man.
Pull out a question.
Pull out a question, yeah. Random ass questions.
Keep it popping.
You ready?
Ready.
Oh, listen. It's written in the stars. Uh-oh. What episode is this?
49.
What I pull out? What number is this?
49.
Come on, what number is this?
Shut up. 49. I'm going to take a photo.
It was in the stars.
Can I take a photo of that shit? Can I take a photo?
That's
crazy. And we're going to take a picture.
Oh, my God. Hey. What's up?
Boom. And the question is so fucking gangster.
What is the question?
It says, what would the world be if it was filled with male and female copies of fucking you?
Copies of you.
Mr. Dark Comedy and Mr. Dark Comedy at.
Wow. Let me take my glasses off.
Oh, he got to take his glasses off. This is a first.
Glasses. It would be a beautiful fucking place.
Yes,
it
beautiful place.
Listen, it would be a lot of babies making songs made. We're going to be laughing all day long.
Wow.
Listen, man.
Yeah.
Listen, man.
If copies the world was filled with copies of you, it would be full of baby making. And good music.
And good music, man.
That's, and good music. Awesome. I fuck with that.
And good shots in the background. Not because we want to hurt nobody, just because we love pop, pop. We love that shit. You know what I'm saying?
Sometimes you still got to shoot shit.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah.
You know, I fucks with shooting shit in like New Year's and up in the air. I think that's a cool little thing that we do.
Yeah. It's pretty normal.
Just don't point it at nobody. Yeah.
I like to shoot in the air. When I'm in the hood and it's a lot of niggas in here that I don't even know and shit.
Yeah.
Let them know.
Right? Let them know that you ain't from here and shit. I like to go in the motherfucking back of the park lot. Blah, 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 blah. Bitch, get your ass home.
He's running. I did two shots. He's
crazy. This nigga running from bullets and shit. Yeah, all weekend.
Whole time.
How dare you run from bullets?
Get a bullet. Oh, sucker ass.
Yeah.
He running from a bullet.
Bitch.
Sit your bitch ass down. Walk to the corner store for me, bitch.
Oh, my God.
Give me some chips. Fuck that.
What kind of chips is he
barbecue.
Barbecue. That is the ghetto chips.
The 50-cent bag.
And an orange Fanta.
It might be the masterpiece.
You want the hold on? Is it in the can? Is it a can Fanta?
Nah, I want the plastic bottle.
I want the plastic. Want the all the.
And don't let them add strawberry. Oh my God.
Lemon.
They playing with my motherfucking name.
Sunflower seeds with vinegar.
Hey, certified sunflower seeds with vinegar.
Sunflower seeds with vinegar.
Yes.
Yeah, that's good shit.
You guys
spitting
win.
All over the fucking plant.
You guys win.
You know a bunch of niggas been in your yard.
Yeah.
We got a bunch.
Nigga, how long was you standing there? It's fucking sunflower season. Then built a fence in front of my house.
Listen, if you wanted to play how to go get it with the little girls in the hood back in the day, come with some sunflower seeds, just shake the motherfucker.
Oh, yeah. Can I have some?
You gonna find him.
Oh, he doesn't got sunflower seeds. And I'm gonna do the booty to you, too.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Shake that. All the little boogers come out that motherfucker.
Not the hood boogers.
Shit, if it wasn't for thoughts, we all be virgins out this motherfucker, man. You better stop playing with them hoes.
No comment.
Hey, you know what, Quan? No comment as well. No comment as well, Quan.
I've been fucking ever since.
Yes. So called my mama.
Let me ask you.
Jesus called my mama a hoe. That's what he did.
Oh,
I have no comment. Like,
Listen, you know when your grandparents, you know when they've been out there fucking and shit. When your grandma, she's like 85 and she say some shit like this. This little nigga dick out. Girl, we at the cookout, but I saw the little motherfucker.
Yeah.
They come out with spurts and that shit. A hoe is a hoe, even if they ain't been hoe in years.
Well, it wasn't a lot to do back in the day. But fuck.
I mean, that's all they had.
Yeah.
And it was all
good. There were no iPhone 13s back then.
Oh, we had bicycles and shit. We put the fan. You was doing something.
Hey, you ain't hear me go down the street.
Right.
You ain't hear me.
Gary, on the green machine.
Go ride the bike. Go ride the tomboy. Go ride that bike.
The tomboy girls had all the best booty, too.
We did.
All the best booty.
Yeah. It's been banged up a little bit. Yeah, you fall off the bike and all that. You get that banana seat the wrong way.
Yeah.
You're fucked up.
See, you ain't having to chase her back and then play how to go get
it. I don't know. I'm going to fall.
She going to be the one to say, look, I'm going to be hiding next to the steps.
God damn. I don't like you running fast and shit.
You don't
get your little 5 pump.
I'll be there. I'm done. I hustled the shit out of him. Hey, but in high school, nigga, there's no bullshit. I was king of the finger popping.
Not finger popping.
Girls should sit back to me like a finger pop.
Lord help.
Pop, 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 pop.
Six.
Goes my mind.
No.
Hey, all the little girls liked me. Hell yeah, the daddies hated me.
Fingering everybody.
Yo, yes. Father.
Yes, sir.
I'm going to ask you this question as well. We from Virginia, man. Y'all are hilarious. Yo, let me ask this question. Where did you two meet?
Oh, I said something under a post because one of my friends commented.
Social media.
Yes.
Wow.
And he tried to get smart with me. And I was try. Not having
he tried
it.
To get smart with Warner. Listen, I checked her ass like the ghost of Christmas past.
Super true.
You hear me? I had to remind her.
And what I tell you to do with your panties? Huh? What I tell you to do with your panties?
I don't remember that part.
I can pull it out.
Listen.
Let me tell you what happened.
This all happened because of the checking. I made a post. This is my shit. On my motherfucker. I made a post because I was about to have sex with a woman. I was about to have sex with this woman, right? And she got on top of me and she's like, ooh, daddy. And I was fucking disgusted. And I'm going to tell you something. The reason I was telling, explaining the situation, that the reason why black women and motherfuckers call people daddy in this country because of the slave master.
That's what he was talking about.
The slave master.
You took it all the way back.
The slave master, those black women out there, they was his daughters. Mm. And he used to make them call him daddy all night long.
Oh, shit.
So the slave master was really having sex with his own daughters by the other slave master, the other slave women.
Wow.
So when she said, call me daddy, I got daughters. You know what I'm saying? When they call me daddy, it's because I'm their fucking daughter. When you call me daddy and we about to do something, you just fucking disgust me. Like, no disrespect. But you know what I'm saying? But pimpin' since fucking sick to pimpin', and I'm an educated motherfucking man. Mm. Calling a man daddy came from a slave master having sex with the babies that he done made.
Damn,
once they came of age, he had sex with them, and he'll say, call me daddy.
Yeah.
You understand me?
What a gross time.
What the fuck? And you do some goofy shit to make it soft. You know I'm a conscious brother.
If that's
so when you come in this bitch,
I get it.
Talking like you walking. My name ain't Daddy, little bitch. I'm not your fucking father. I'm not your father. You done fucked it up. You freaky. You too freaky.
You really freaky.
You nasty.
Come on, Daddy.
Did your daddy raise you, little bitch? Because I'm not your fucking father. Nah, what are you saying? Talk to me.
To each his own.
But yeah, that's
how. So back to the story. She jumped up there and she said some slick shit. So I
popped. And then Quado, you all became
the best friend.
Hey, when your birthday is
what? March 18th.
Mine is the 20th.
We both Pisces.
Yeah.
I was 2 days.
Y'all 2 days apart.
I'm first. I'm 46. I'm all older.
Man, you've been first.
Come on. Respect your elders. Don't come out here.
Yeah. Whatever.
Now, she funny as a motherfucker.
She's hilarious.
Yeah, but I'm a motherfucker.
He ain't like that shit.
I'm Mr. Dog Comedy. Mr. Dog, what the fuck? And I checked the shit like properly. That's why we here together.
So, now we here together.
You know what? I'm going to jump into this because y'all are comedians.
Yeah.
Dave Chappelle's new joint
that
came out. I'm going to answer that question. I'm putting this down.
We closer.
The closer. What'd you think about
it? Let's start from the beginning.
How do I start from the beginning? What you mean?
What did he say that you found of offensive or not offensive? Let's start from the beginning.
Nothing offended me.
So what did he say?
I'm not white or I'm gay.
Transgender.
But hold on, I'm not white or gay, but I gotta say this.
Yeah.
I do identify with a 25-year-old lesbian.
I know you do. You identify, I put your pants.
Why would it up? What does that mean?
I mean, okay.
No, please, I would like you to identify with a 25-year-old lesbian.
I identify with a 25-year-old lesbian. Why?
You feel like your other portion of you is a 25-year-old lesbian.
Yeah, for one.
What color?
Huh?
She's black.
She's black. I just gotta ask. I don't know.
Yeah, of course.
She's a lesbian already, guys.
Right. So if I was reincarnated and I had to be a woman, I would be a lesbian. Because one, right now in my life, a nigga never fucked me over. Mentally, physically, spiritually, anyway. I've never been fucked. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
So if I had to be reincarnated and come out as a woman, right? And a black woman, she should be a lesbian. Because why? If you catch me in the bathroom having sex with another woman, come and fuck down. I'm a lesbian. That's what we do.
Would you be the lipstick lesbian or would you be the
man? I'm a dyke. I'm a whole dyke. I'm a fucking man. I'm a whole
dyke.
I'm a whole Manny Fresh, Lil Wayne.
Oh my God.
I'm a whole dad, because I'm about to check these niggas. Because I'm gonna be a sexy ass motherfucking lesbian.
You know, I'm gonna tell you. I've seen a meme where they had this real pretty young lady dressed as a male.
I'm a bulldog.
So I'm gonna say I would not be attracted to
you. You know what? And me as a lesbian on the inside, I want you fucking.
Really cool as shit though.
But I will fuck your bitch if you catch me slipping.
You fuck my bitch.
If I'm a dyke, respect my dyke hood.
Nah, my dick down is dope.
Don't disrespect the lesbian.
I'm not gonna disrespect it, but my dick down.
I didn't say everybody.
It's better than plastic. It's way better than plastic.
I tell you,
respect everybody.
I respect no matter what the fuck. I don't get look different, feel different.
I don't give a fuck.
That's not my fucking business.
But when you violate and fuck with little kids and stuff like that, that's where I got a problem.
But hurt people hurt people.
But I would say that. That he definitely, Chappelle definitely spoke up when nobody else wanted to. They was worried about, everybody's worried about being canceled. Everybody's apologizing for things that they previously said to be accepted.
Yeah.
And he is no nonsense. He's not going to apologize for shit he said.
He said it. He's going to stand on his shit.
And when they asked him, they said, well, how you feel about being canceled? He said, fuck, that shit already got paid.
I got paid. He said he also stayed in the joint. I walked away from $50 million. Before.
Yeah, he did. And then.
Listen,
they don't want you.
And you know, the thing about the industry is, especially when it comes to comedy,
you're delving into it right now.
I'm in the business.
So tell us about what's going on. You about to tell us.
Listen, and I got
extremely funny. It's fucking hilarious.
I mean, we talked for
these glasses. We talked for how long? We talked
forever.
We talked all fucking
days. At least about 2-3 hours.
Yeah.
She was cooking chicken, burping a grandbaby and everything. I think I heard a fist one time, but I didn't want to ask her. I was hoping she was making coffee.
You flushed? Did you flush? You left me here to flush.
I would say I will be right back. I'm not about to do all that.
I heard tripping.
Now you heard tripping.
It could have been just fried chicken.
You must have a nice phone.
But I'm retarded, so my imagination, if you let it go somewhere, it's going to go somewhere.
Nah, we talked for a while. He's fucking hilarious.
Great energy.
Yes.
Great energy.
Yes. From jump.
That's when you know that someone is a genuine person.
Yeah.
Because it's like, I'm going to tell you, this is the truth.
Yeah.
When I was on the West Coast, that's when I really started knowing that I can go on stage and tell my story. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And with white, black, no matter race, mm-hmm. I'm going to make you laugh. And I'm going to say what the fuck I
That's
say.
That's the job.
You know, the thing about Mr. Dark Comedy, you never going to hear me do nobody else's shit.
Yes.
Ever.
Yeah, yeah.
I have too much experience in my life. Like I said, I've been selling drugs since I was 10.
Yeah.
I've been going to the prison since I was 13.
Yeah.
This is documented facts.
Yeah.
I can't make this shit up.
Right.
You know, and I've survived in motherfucking places where niggas will kill you for nothing.
Not
that. Oh, yeah.
You feel me? Exactly. And I went out there and I fought with grown ass men because I come from a disgruntled ass family. Mm. So my mother be like, my grandmother had 8 daughters. We had no uncles. So she like, go to your aunt house. While we walking over there, me and my brother's looking for bats and sticks because we know her boyfriend probably put her hands on her.
Yeah.
So we gonna go and beat this nigga ass. It was no question. So we was raised up like pit bulls.
Mm.
Like from right here to the motherfucking exit, it'll take 15 police officers, and they gonna have to change shifts to get me from here to the motherfucking door. Because I'm a mega wolf, and I ain't going for shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about?
No, I feel
and it's not even being no arrogant, because I'm built for shit.
But you brought that over to your hustle, your grind for the comedy, it seems like.
I was always doing comedy. I just had to tune in on what I was great at.
When did that tune in occur?
When I was in prison.
Okay.
I was in prison, and I was selling motherfucking vegetables and shit, green vegetables. I had a store box and shit, right?
So a nigga that I fuck with from Chicago and shit, I got him a job in the motherfucking joint. He was such an ass-kissing motherfucker, and I knew that he could work his motherfucker.
You got him. Did you get him?
No, that nigga's
we've been trying to catch this motherfucker, dog. We'll catch that nigga.
He almost got me.
It's two of them niggas.
Almost got me. Oh, no. I thought I had a flashback.
As long as you felt good at the end, I was out of it. So I hooked him up in the kitchen and shit. Yeah. So he got to end up working in the CO office and shit.
Wow. Mm.
Serving the COs. Wow. Right? So I get this nigga my stamps and shit, and I give it to my homie to get him. Stamps. Like booking stamps, the mail letters.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
That's just fucking money, right? So I give it to the nigga, and he go in the motherfucker, and he give me more onions than green peppers.
What?
Oh, Lord.
Right, nigga, I can't hustle this shit. I said, look, bitch, tell that nigga, I said, mix my shit up. I'll bring back my stamps. He brought back a stupid. No, let me get that. That's mine. But I never want to leave that.
Keep it.
I'm about to put it in the max. I don't know
how the hell it ripped, but. It was that powerful.
No, right. It was no doubt. So what happened was, I went back and I said, okay, this motherfucker playing with me, and then he talking shit to me and shit.
Right, you know right.
What I'm talking about? Yeah. I can't let that shit happen. No way, no how.
Nope.
Yeah. Even when I went in there as a juvenile, I went in there at 13 years old, and I started whooping niggas' ass because that's how I had to be. Yeah. So now I'm an adult and I fuck with these grown men. I'm gonna put all heads to bed, off top. You feel me? Win or lose, you're going to know I was there.
You got to survive.
I'm going to survive.
Yeah, yeah. I feel you.
I'm going to wake up dead.
Right. I'm going
to I'm the type of nigga,
survive.
I'm going to wake up dead.
I feel you.
Why? Because I came in for the win.
Yeah.
Mm.
Now, if it so happened that I slip and this motherfucker get the best of me, I ain't going to feel it. I'm going to wake up dead. God, what's next for me?
Yeah, what's next, man?
Because you can drop me anywhere in the motherfucking world.
You're
going to
be
survive.
A lesbian.
That's right.
I'm going to be a lesbian, too.
Yeah. 25-year-old.
And guess
two.
What?
He's going to want to come to at 25,
and guess
too.
What? Not near nigga going to fuck me.
I know.
But hold on. That's between right. 0 and 25, because he said you're a 25-year-old lesbian.
Yeah.
Between 0 and 25, are you not a lesbian?
I'm always a lesbian. But I'm always.
You always knew,
beat
but.
Niggas up in
but,
fucking business.
But you claimed it at 25.
I claimed it a few months ago.
Oh, okay.
Because you're like,
oh my Lord, wait.
I'm gonna tell you what happened.
Wait,
because if
man.
You know me, I'm a jazzy motherfucker,
a few months
and
ago.
I always smell good. You know what I'm saying?
I'm gonna attest to that. And I love the sneaker game is hard.
Oh. Yeah, I'm a fly motherfucker.
Fly motherfucker.
I'm tripping in my own sauce.
I'm gonna take a photo of the picture.
So, yeah, they are. The LeBron.
So
they are.
And
nice.
Plus, my hygiene is better than any woman I ever slept with. You feel me? Because I keep it clean. You feel me? I soak. I
he
do
got
all
a lot
that
of
shit.
Fucking bath shit.
All that shit. You know,
I seen it.
Manicure, pedicures. Because
word.
I know this by being in prison, growing up in prison. Mm. Ain't nobody going to love me like I love myself.
That's right.
Most definitely. Most
and that's
definitely.
Why I've been single. Facts. This is the longest I've been single. And I've been making a lot of fucking mistakes. Because I've been fucking people that shouldn't get fucked. But I did it
oh,
real
Lord,
well.
Help us.
Yeah, you know what I'm talking about? Come you know what I'm saying? And the drugs don't help.
Hey.
Listen, I went in the motherfucking club. Before the Molly and after the Molly, I came home with a gorilla, but she fucked the shit out of me. So I can't be mad that she did her fucking job. Just
Look this way a little bit. Don't look at me. It ain't even dark enough in that motherfucker.
But I said to myself, like, you look ugly, bitch. Got the fire.
Yeah. Oh Lord.
So it was fire. Okay.
So
in there riding a bull.
Yeah. So you know,
he stayed off. But
I'm the fucking bull. I'm the bull. Lord. You know what I'm saying? I'm the animal in the factor.
Oh,
but like I said, you know, through all my trials and tribulations or whatever, you know what I mean? I've learned to deal with long suffering.
Right.
You know, I don't got room to complain.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I don't got room to judge people because. Yeah. I've done shit that I can never change, or you know, but I don't regret shit.
How long you been doing this?
Far as what?
Comedy.
Oh, like I said, for 7 years. This is my God year. This is my seven years.
Damn.
This is my 7 years.
We on God year right now.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Cheers to that.
Yeah, yeah, man. Yeah.
Cheers to that. Cheers to that.
This is my God year.
49 with the number.
Yeah, and I've came into realizing, you know, Mr. Dark Comedy.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And because of how I groom myself, how I love myself, mm-hmm. that's why I've been single, because, like, I'm a faithful person.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? I'm a faithful person all the way around. I'm a loyal person. That's mm-hmm. just to the bottom of me. Mm-hmm. But I'm a spiteful motherfucker.
As
don't
a
think
motherfucker.
You're going to do something to me and get away with it. You got
you're
me
not.
Fucked up.
Yeah.
And I'm going to make sure that you know I did it, bitch.
Yes.
You feel me?
Stamp that.
Yes.
Because
people have done shit to me that I would never think about doing
going to them.
And
yes.
guess what? I'm gonna make you understand you would never do it again. Baby.
No. I don't even know why you tried it.
Right. So,
what then? What brought the name Dark Mr. Dark Comedy?
I was high as fuck.
Okay. Hilarious. What were you smoking? What remember the?
I'm not gonna tell you that
thing?
Because I'm looking for my wife, and she be like, "Nigga, did you just say you did that? I did that, and I was fucked up, right?
You was fucked up.
I was fucked up. Let's say.
What time was it?
I swear I don't know.
Because I wonder how fucked up he was.
That's how fucked up I was.
What time
was
it?
That's some good shit.
Was the sun out?
Huh?
Was the sun out?
Probably was.
I know what time.
I was in my fucking bag, right? And I just did a stand-up joint, right?
Uh-huh.
I was just in stand-up. I came up there, Sandy Artist. That's my name, Sandy Artist.
Sandy Artist.
You know, Sandy Artist. Sandy Ray Artist Jr.
Sandy Ray Artist Jr.
Yes. Right? So, so I just did the joint, and I was in there, and I was high as fuck. And it's just like something just came over.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? Because
I was
so good when I went up there.
Yeah.
Everybody just fucking had to talk to me.
Yeah.
Like, I couldn't even leave.
Yeah.
And I was like, damn it.
So you could have walked out, everybody was like,
felt good.
Yeah, I took out a video picture.
You killed it.
And I'm a nigga from the hood. I've been going to prison since going to prison. You understand?
Yeah, you've been going to prison since going to prison.
Since going to prison.
So I'm getting off this stage, and I got all nationalities. These motherfuckers would not let me go.
Yeah.
And when I finally got by myself, I was crying.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I was getting high. I was crying. And I was like, man, I'm not what the fuck they said I was. Because these motherfuckers say to me that I'm crazy. I've never been crazy. You could not achieve the things that I've accomplished if I was crazy.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying? I'm just determined. And I'm not going to allow nobody to do nothing. I believe one thing, that you can never find God in another man's mouth.
Never.
So my God talks to me personally. I see through the signs what he want from me.
Yeah.
You know, but another motherfucker can't tell me what God want from me or not burning him.
Real.
Like, nigga, fuck.
Yeah.
Right? So at this point in time, like, I'm in my motherfucking bag, and I started saying, yo, I'm like fucking Mr. Dark Comedy.
Yeah.
And I said that shit in my most... I've never been so proud of my fucking self.
It was a realization.
Yes.
You feel me?
Yeah.
And I said, Mr. Dark Comedy, fucking MR dot motherfucking DA fucking R to the fucking K to the fucking O to the CO to the M to the E to the D to the fucking Y. Mr. Dark Comedy, no space in the middle. Uh-huh. So when you say it, you're going to say Mr. with it. You know what I'm saying? Dark comedy, because my comedy came out of all my pain.
Yeah.
I had to learn to laugh at myself.
That's where it come from.
And my suffering. Everybody notice, my kids, I have a son named Thomas. I have a daughter, he's 27. I have a daughter named Chase, she's 15. They live in Waldorf too. I have a daughter named Jaja, she's 11. She lives in Waldorf. My Jaja and Thomas. So Jaja and Chase got the same mother, Thomas got their mother. Both of my baby mothers are strippers and whores, right?
Here we go.
Listen, this is facts. Both of my kids, everybody know me. I can't make this shit up. Yeah. I met my son's mother, I was 15, she was 23. Like, I was fucking on Jasper Street, Southeast, right?
I know what that is.
Right? And she was a dancer at classes and shit. They call her name was Kisses, right? They used to have her on flyers and shit and all this motherfucking time, right? So I'm up in here with my best friend. I can say this. This is documented facts.
Not real shit, though.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I can say this. I got committed of a murder charge in 1998, and I did 19 months and 3 weeks before they acquitted me and sent me home. Right? That's me.
Yo, what was that?
So I'll tell you something. So
hold on.
Spread time. I say that, you know, I was 15 and she was 23.
Uh-huh.
So I was out on the block hustling and shit with my best friend. He stuttered like a motherfucker, right? And she had a flat tire and she asked me to change the tire. I don't know shit about changing tire, but my man does.
Yeah.
Right? So she just started coming every day. She's gonna give me fucking 62s, 31s, big blocks of crack and shit. Don't ask for no money, weed and everything. You're like, she was grooming the fuck out of me.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
My name is Sandy Artist. They call me Stink. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I grew up on 4th and Chesapeake.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? Everything I say is fact. Yeah. My mother was married to a man named Robert Jones. He had a gospel group called The Faith of Five. They had 4 albums.
Wow.
But they was all gangsters and drug dealers.
Wow.
I watched them people that grew me. They grew up me to be a gangster all fucking day. And as me growing up, I watched them all die.
Mm-hmm.
And I went from state to state singing songs with this gospel group that was real live gangsters.
Mm-hmm.
I could say this shit. And, you know, we laugh. And can't nobody fucking check me because I'm not lying. I got to. No reason to.
I understand. Yeah.
If you say my name from where I'm from, it's going to come with respect.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because I've been hustling since I was 10 years old, man.
So all that is what spurned, like, it brought you to say dark comedy.
I
want to get big words, and then my big word got fucking. Yo, be nice. Huh?
Yeah, God.
Yo, Quanta, you know what?
What
my man brought something with me.
We both tagged
it.
No, like real shit.
I'm sorry.
Because you born this shit, you bringing things to life. Right? Right?
Your son, most definitely.
Real life. You know, we build and destroy. Build and destroy.
So, and your comedy is real. I saw your stand-up act, everything that Quanta sent me over, and I went deep into your Facebook page and I watched. Yeah. We need to be talking to the
talking
camera.
Shit. Yeah.
Talking shit, yo.
He was cussing the police out. Called him a
little bitches.
How do you feel about social media right now and being a comedian? Do you think you have to take advantage of social media? And if you guys have any questions, please, this is my man right here, my young man right here. He's out here. I want him to soak up all the game he can. All the great people we bring in here. You have a question, please, you guys. Quanta, ask. At any given moment, please.
Oh, absolutely.
When it comes to social media, I don't even say taking advantage of it because I'm an old school and I've done a lot of underground comedy. Mm-hmm. And once I get there, I got a cousin. Shout out to Arita Artist. No, she's
Arita.
She's a partner with Kevin Hart's ex-wife. Her daughter has 2 kids by Mike Epps. So in the top of the year, you know, I'm gonna be in Texas with my man Charlie Mack. Yes. You know, doing his roast out there, and I'm trying to catch this Cat Williams City. With Williams ticket with Sauce in the City of Vegas.
Absolutely.
So, you know what I mean? So, and I say this, like, it's real shit. Like,
amen, bro.
When I say it, I mean this shit. Like, I'm in the motherfucking game.
I only fuck
with real motherfuckers. Let me tell you something. When I came back to the East Coast where I'm from,
yeah,
I dealt with all the motherfucking hate. I couldn't find a comedy team and motherfuckers to deal with because they were so mad at my style. But they didn't know a lot of pain came
from
that shit.
Right, exactly.
Everybody wanted to be shit, but y'all motherfucker, I done been 28 states by myself, sleeping in my motherfucking car, getting up to do the next show. Whether it's Atlanta, Georgia, you know what I'm saying, Ohio, you know what I'm saying? And I just stopped in Arizona because it was so fucking beautiful, and I got a relationship, you know what I'm saying?
What you like about Arizona? You 28, Arizona.
Yeah.
Pause. You in Arizona. What made you stop in Arizona?
I fell in love with a talented ass woman, man.
That's what it is. Okay.
Real live shit, you know.
Love.
And real shit. And coming from where I come from, you know what I'm saying? it was the first time I can say that I really fell in love with a woman.
Yeah.
Wow.
You know
yeah.
what I'm saying? I've been fucking since fucking. Hey. But this is the first time that I really say I fell in love with a woman.
Yeah.
And she was so talented. But, you know, just dealing with me not having no family shit over there, like, her family and everybody else, like, my
style.
Yeah,
you gotta keep
just,
family out your damn business.
Yeah. Yo, yeah. number
you
fucking
You gotta keep
one.
The family out your motherfucking business.
Don't talk to them. Her family, I love her family. They talented.
But you can't,
her
you
mother
can't,
and
but
father
you can't,
used
business.
To sing background for Smokey Robinson.
Ooh,
this is facts.
Oh, they bad.
You know what I'm saying? But it was just, Smokey. You know, they're older. Yeah. He's a preacher. Mm. And, you know, I'm Mr. Dark Comedy.
You who you are.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh,
you feel me?
But you know what? But if you was in the game, you got to be able to adapt to somebody in the game. That means.
So what would be the perfect woman at this point
for where you are
right now?
In my life, somebody just like I'm all more in my mind.
Right.
Like I fuck when I want to, and I mean that shit. You know
okay,
I mean?
Bill.
You know, I really do. I ain't gonna pop a pill or nothing. You know what I'm saying?
Well, we fucking
I
know
deal,
as you
I deal,
fucking.
I deal with the law of attraction.
As we fucking you know or as I'm fucking.
Somebody fucking. I'm going to tell you this. I came in here to fuck, right? And if she came in here to pussy for the real, she can't be the bullshit.
Not pussy for
She better come in here to fuck too, or she going to be unsatisfied. Like, I ain't come. That's your fault.
Oh, Lord.
You
want
cared.
Me to do all the motherfucking word and shit, and still you want to get off? Get the fuck out of here, man.
Next.
You gotta throw the work in too.
You gotta come in here like
50-50.
It's the zoo. The zoo.
You're on your right track with the wrong train.
Baby.
You missed it.
Do you have a question, Quada, for Mr. Doug?
Yes, I want to know your top three celebrity influences.
Ooh.
Ooh, ladies. Off top.
Okay.
Tupac Shakur.
Of course. Ooh. You know that.
And why?
Yes, there
you
we
know
go.
What I mean? Off top, Tupac Shakur, because I relate to that young brother on so many different levels, you know, because being a talented person that's know yourself and your self-worth and you still in the hood,
mm-hmm.
you know, niggas gonna try to kill you. Like, I've been through an incident where I had a family member try to set me up, you know, in the last week ago.
Damn.
You know what I'm saying? And
right.
The police... Good killed cream. my baby cousin off of MLK.
Oh,
Anthony
yeah, we
Lewis.
Did talk about that.
Mm-hmm. You feel me? They tased him and hit him, and he fell 40 feet off the Malcolm X Bridge. And then when he got down, he was bleeding everywhere. They handcuffed him, and they dragged him. It's all over the internet for the world to see.
Damn.
You feel me? So I'm like, fuck the police. And then on top of it, then when they y'all killed my motherfucking baby cousin, my motherfucking mother, I was driving her car, and I was in the same projects. And my mother's car gets shot up and shit. But I saw the nigga who did it. And he passed me like, bro, I ain't mean to. Yeah, little bitch, that gun too big for you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know what I'm saying? I couldn't say, you know, anything because I'm driving with no motherfucking license. And that's how they get a nigga. That's how they get a nigga. I sold drugs. What does drugs got to do with my fucking driver's license? I sold drugs. Y'all lock me up and tell me I can't get my driver's license because I sold drugs. Now I owe the fucking DMV $3,500.
Yo. Bitch. Let's talk about that, yo. If VA, yo, everybody, this is number one.
Oh, Lord.
Have your driver's license. And
it's not that easy,
game.
My nigga.
It's not.
Not especially, listen.
But you got to.
Listen,
somehow
you got to.
You gotta
you
figure
got
that
to.
Shit out. That's the math
just,
of Virginia.
Listen, they just made a new law. They just made a new law that separated your fucking drug convictions and shit with DMV.
Yeah, exactly.
You can't suspend my license.
They suspend your license if
over drug
cards.
So, guys, let me tell you what I did. I moved over to VA, Maryland.
Yes.
I moved to Maryland. Come to PG County. Come to PG County.
You know,
please,
but so,
black folk.
But
please,
no, so anyway,
folk.
So the car gets shot up. So, motherfuckers was playing favors and shit. My family got separated after my cousin got murdered. And motherfuckers put the fans on me. So I'm like, I got fans in my business, all types of shit.
That's why you say you relate to Pac more than anybody.
Yeah, because it's like my family is my worst haters. Like, you know what I'm saying? My family see that the blessings that God give you. They see how it is. A stranger would come and say, yo, you talented.
They would encourage
and they embrace
you. Absolutely.
Me.
Yes,
now,
they do.
You got to understand.
But let me ask you this one before you go there. Do you think that's... I started believing that's what it's all about.
We talked about that.
Yeah, but that I started feeling like that's what it's all about.
What it's all about.
Meaning that, yeah, you expect your family is going to be the one to ride with you.
Right down, baby.
But then sometimes it just be about them niggas that don't even know.
Check out. It's 2021. We are awoke, right?
We awoke.
The saying blood is thicker than water is saying the opposite of what you think it's saying.
Yeah.
What it's saying is that people don't have to be your blood to be your family.
That's right.
Yeah. Right? And I've been shot 5 times. Mm. You know what I'm saying? I've been stabbed 6 times. Wow. I got fucking bullet holes in my legs and shit. I got an artificial heel. I got bullet holes in my back. You know what I'm talking about? I got knife wounds down my head.
And you're still attacking.
Yeah, because I don't give a fuck, yo. Word. Like, listen, this is only a pound of flesh. I'm going to say what I got to say.
Hey.
You know what I'm talking about? You're going to kill me saying what the fuck I got
to
say.
That's it.
You're going to wake up to God.
That's it.
I'm going to wake up whatever the fuck ever.
Yeah, but you know, you said earlier, you're going to wake up to God. You're going all the way.
I'm going to wake up to my creator, him, her, or whatever, whoever him or her is.
Yeah.
And I'm going to say, listen, man, you know they was fucking me.
Yeah. Hey,
I was born black, son.
You know what I'm talking about? See, we read the Bible, B-I-B-L-E, Better Instructions Before Leaving Earth,
that's
right?
That's right.
We read the Bible. It's been finger popped so many motherfucking times.
If you say that again, the Bible acronym again?
It's Better Instructions Before Leaving Earth. Life,
yeah. Better Instructions
See, Before because Earth. Now, there's a lot of truth in it, but a lot of falsehood. See, I'm gonna tell you something about my creator, right? Mm. My creator is not a man, right? Or a woman, in fact. You know, my creator is not gonna get happy, mad, sad, and all this other shit. My creator ain't gonna say, hey man, go down there and find muff. They don't believe in me? Fuck it. I'm gonna flood this bitch for 42 days and 42 nights. This is a characteristic of a human being.
Yeah.
God won't kill motherfuckers because we don't believe in you. We down here in the land of the living, God.
Yeah.
You gonna judge me because a nigga tricked me?
Yeah.
You got motherfucking women that get kidnapped and raped and get Stockholm Syndrome and they'll do anything for this motherfucker.
That's right.
You gonna blame her? Come on, man. See, my God is not a man. Yeah. I'm a man. You do something to me, bitch, I ain't never gonna forgive you. And if I catch you slipping, guess what? You're gonna recognize.
So, who's the second person?
The second person.
And why?
The second person is Frederick Douglass. And coming because, you know, I got my father's name. I look like my father, but the bitch never loved me. You know what I'm saying? So I used to pretend like Frederick Douglass was my father. You know
what I'm saying?
So I used to read everything about him and shit. And it was things about him that, you know, as I got older and I understood it, I didn't agree with. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, you know, I understood the big picture.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? And the big picture is that, you know, everything comes from us. Mm. The forefathers of this country, they never hated us because they never loved us. You can't love something that you hate. They was jealous of us. They still jealous of us. They know if you mix anything with black, it's going to be black. EPMD said back in the days, fear of a black planet. Now, you look at the ratio, white people like what? 18 to 25% of the world. And they know their population is dying out because you realize how great and how good we are.
We busting at everybody's door.
Everybody
right
calling. Listen, I was there to fucking show in Colorado and I wanted to smoke some fucking weed, but the niggas there was up and I said, I ain't gonna fucking smoke weed. Right?
Yeah, you can't. Yeah, nah.
I'm gonna go, I gotta find some niggas. Yeah. I couldn't find nobody. So I had this back.
He said, I couldn't find nobody.
That is like in this fucking like house.
I know who he found.
In this house. In this house, like it was like a back, like a fucking like a, like a, it was like an apartment on top of their land or some shit. Right,
I bet you it was fire shit.
Right? So, that's fire as fuck, bro. And then I went to the back and I heard a motherfucker kept arguing and said, man, nigga, fuck you, nigga. Man, fuck you, nigga.
All them niggas right there.
So I'm looking for the entrance. Yeah. And I go with that motherfucker and I lie to you, fucking. I can't make this shit up.
Yes.
It's a Spanish dude and a white dude.
Oh, yes.
Calling each other niggas.
That's right.
Listen.
Those are niggas.
You I got put my hands on them motherfucking niggas.
Yeah. Now, my niggas. Right there.
I said, y'all killing these other niggas? I'm the only nigga in here.
Let him know.
Hold on, my nigga. Fast, yeah. Like this motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? I whoop their motherfucking
gotta
ass.
Gotta let a nigga know.
I'm going to jail tonight. You know what I'm talking about?
Where the weed at?
Only reason I'm trying to go to jail now because I don't want a motherfucker to shoot me up with no shit.
Yeah, you got to get vaccinated.
I ain't got to get God. Nothing.
They're going to put it in you.
Keep going with the story, baby. Keep going with the story.
So that was Frederick Douglass. And that's why. So what's the third one?
He slapped the dude. Oh, he got good weed. The good weed story.
Right. So it's Pac, Frederick Douglass, and Prince.
And Prince. And why Prince?
Well, because Prince is one of the most talented brothers I've ever had a chance to enjoy his music throughout my life.
Wow, wow.
Mm-hmm. You know, he played multiple instruments, and he was a troubled brother like most of us brothers are. I mean, we had to deal with, you know,
black favorite type. Song by Prince?
It's got to be Purple Rain.
Yes!
Purple Rain. You know what I mean? Because, you know, and that, you know, that was his father's song.
Did you like the movie?
Listen, Arlington had a movie theater, right?
Where? Draft House?
I don't remember what it is. It's by when you could catch the... Arlington, Alexandria. Okay, it's a bridge. Like a bike trail where you cross the bridge.
Yeah.
And you go down Delray and you go into Arlington, right?
Okay.
Yeah, you gotta get through Shirley Park.
The first time my brother, the first time my brother ever did anything for me, your oldest brother, he took me and my other brother Greg to the movies. Okay. And we saw Purple Rain.
Yeah.
Purple Rain in the theaters.
Man. No, right, in Arlington,
awesome.
Right?
Arlington.
Awesome.
Right? And it was like the fucking work of art.
Yeah.
And just, that movie just changed me. And I started listening to his music, and I was like, yo, this dude is fucking everything.
Yo, son, so favorite scene in the movie? Come on.
Lake Minnetonka.
Lake Minnetonka?
Because I ain't playing with you little bitches.
In the waters of Lake Minnetonka.
I'm not playing with you little bitches. That's the story of my life. If you're the woman for me, you know I'm traumatized. You know I've been through shit. So I'm going to test you a little bit.
But if you get the whole Purple Rain, like,
oh, shit.
Time period, like time with that woman, yeah, that's a badass motherfucker. I'll give you that. Shit. You got to keep that motherfucker. Yeah. If she make you feel like you're with the lake,
it was like, get on my bike.
And he had the purple bike.
She like, stop playing with me.
He had the, you seen that movie?
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I ain't playing with you. I just want to know if you going to ride with me.
Yeah, that was it.
Like, if I get you mad and you fucked up with me.
Are you still going to ride with me?
Are you still going to ride with me?
That's the question.
Hey,
word.
Because I'm an ignorant ass nigga.
So she proved she was ride or die.
And she, I knew.
I would love my man. Hey, yo, I want my man Witches to ask you a question.
All right, brother, all right.
Man, a brother in the game, doing his thing, killing it, hilarious as you can tell.
Nah,
what's the question you got?
I appreciate you being here.
Yeah.
Hey, man, I'm grateful.
Yeah, for real.
I'm grateful.
I'll just have to ask you, since, you know, you're older than me, where do you really see yourself 5 years from now? Where would you hope to be?
That's a good one.
And I say this in all ignorance and shit.
I understand.
In the most ignorant.
I say this in the most ignorant way possible.
I really don't give a fuck. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Word.
You know what I'm saying? I live for the day, but I'm trying to prepare for tomorrow. Right, you know, my it's not about me. It's about my kids, you know? So right now, it's like, I'm doing everything I'm doing to build a foundation for them. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
for them. You know, so that they can, you know, be proud of this little ghetto boy. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And to see that at the end of my life, right? At the end of my physical life, I felt who I was, and I did everything in
the
my
most
power.
Amazing feeling to make it happen. To know who you are.
It's called self-actualization.
Yeah. Oh, I like that.
And it's
like
in the middle
that.
Of the trenches. I found myself in the middle of the trenches.
I didn't come up with that. That's from Maslow, Hierarchy of Needs.
The
final stage of life is self-actualization.
I never heard of it, but it makes sense.
It makes sense.
Please
to me.
Read that the triangle.
You have to text
send it to me.
I will text you. The first level. I'm going to let you know the first.
Write that shit down.
Y'all, I'm going to text y'all
get
niggas.
A pen.
And let me tell you.
Hand me a pen and piece of paper.
I hope you don't think
we don't pen no more. So I will text you. But yes. I'm going to tell you that the first level of the Maslow Hierarchy of Needs is food, sex, and water.
Oh, yes. Makes
fucking
sense.
Plays a lot of part. Listen. For one, I'm single, and I don't mind being single. It's been good to me.
I can tell you enjoy. You said it about three times.
But I know that one good woman trumps a thousand of these bad ass bitches any day.
That's fact.
But it's quite fun trying to find the one.
Right.
And you got to kiss a few frogs or bulls or whatever.
Yeah. But the thing about it is, this is the thing in my mind, because I'm a street nigga all the time.
Hey.
You've been fucking and sucking for a long time. Don't get with me and we get married and I can't hit that from the side whatever the fuck I feel like.
Oh, Lord.
If I ask for the shit, what you want, baby? It's a commercial one. I don't think I get a head.
3 minutes.
Huh?
Just lick the tip.
3 minutes.
Get in there and dive deep, bitch. What the fuck? You the fucking Ernest Tyrone and the niggas used to beat on you, cheat on you. You gonna get with me, baby, and you gonna deny me in the fucking booty? I'm cheating.
You know this is my favorite commercial.
Huh? You better know it. rice garroni, the several sugar seeds, it's your beans and rice, bitch. Let me hit that shit real quick.
Oh, Lord.
Like, your favorite commercial? So, man, we asked you that. Any more questions, guys? You have any more questions?
No, I'm good. I'm trying to compose myself.
Thank you for coming through again.
Oh, man, I'm in the building, man.
We're going to have you shake up and ask another question.
Do one more?
Man, listen. I look like a black leprechaun, man. That's because it's dick, bullets, and comedy at the end of the motherfucking rainbow. Dick, that depends on how the fuck you come.
Comedy.
Depending on where how the fuck you rainbow come.
At?
Huh?
Where the rainbow at?
It's goddamn follow the shit in the daytime.
Well, he looks like a follow it
in the daytime. Only in the daytime.
Listen, rainbow must be
fucking with me and get some money.
Like shit.
I like that. Fuck with me and get some money, man.
It's gonna be, it's gonna lead into a corner store.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's gonna be a corner store.
And all that shit.
Hold on. Who got you drunk, son?
You done told me where the fuck shit at. And then Rex co-signed the shit. Rex was like, it's right there. Everything right there. Ice is right
ice
there.
Is right.
I don't know what the fuck y'all did.
That nigga got an ice machine.
Yeah. Y'all made me feel more than hope at home and shit. I feel like I should have took off these motherfucking shoes.
Take the shoes off, baby. Take the shoes off.
See, but when the fuck he said it to me?
We said, come around back.
They come down the stairs. They're going to say, come around back and come downstairs. I said, hold up.
Yeah. Hey, this girl to set me up.
You welcome. You welcome. Room on the motherfucker. Yeah, let me get my motherfucking GED together.
Oh, shit.
It says, what are some fun ways to answer everyday questions like, how?
No, we asked that last week. He put that back in the joint. No.
Who asked that?
They love asked that.
Oh, God.
I edit these
you
joints.
You can't use a condom twice.
No, you cannot. It better be yours, too, man.
We going to use that.
If you're going to use it again.
See if that one fits you.
I'd rather just go hard, man.
It's three of them over there.
I trust you. I'm a gorilla fucking stuff. I trust you.
Huh? What's the trust factor in the raw dog in the poo-poo?
The trust factor is her motherfucking baby father husband is not flash. By the time I pull my dick out of the van, he ain't gonna catch me. He can't run up and catch me from here.
Oh my God.
That's why I got trust issues right now.
I see.
A little bit.
It makes sense. Listen, I done played girls' cousins, brothers, and all this shit. I didn't play. Listen, the best relationship I had in.
Hey, brother.
I'm about to send this nigga to the store. Yeah. Hey, bro, can you give us some blunts? Yes, I got all the weed.
Yes. Oh, my God.
Hey, sis, it's been a good night, fucking night.
Oh, my God. I'm crying. I got tears in my eyes.
What happened?
What you got now?
All right. It says, Mr. Dark Comedy is dripping in his own motherfucking sauce, baby.
It is.
But I'm not. I'm ready to save the money.
It's all good.
Read the damn thumb.
It says, in one sentence, how would you sum up the internet?
Okay, cool.
Some weird shit. I'm a weird motherfucker, right? I'm a weird motherfucker, but when it comes to the internet, I'm very cautionary with my daughters, you know? Like, back in the days, it was a truck, a white van or something to pick you up. You had to watch for that
motherfucker. Yeah, yeah.
But even worse, you know, in the black community, you know, most of the people that's been raping and pedophiling our little boys and our little girls.
They in the family.
They in the family or close to the motherfucking family.
Mm-hmm.
And when they find out who it is, they will shun the kid.
I don't see nobody doing that.
And raise the fucking adult. Yeah. That's some cold hearted shit.
That's some cold.
You
know,
and I'm gonna make you laugh, but I'm gonna tell you the truth at the same time.
Yeah.
So when it comes to the internet, you know, you gotta be mindful. I'm on all my daughters everything.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You know what they're doing.
I will call them the fuck up. Like, hold on, what the fuck is you doing? I was just dancing. Dance like your leg's broken.
Yeah.
Or I'm gonna come over to that motherfucker and I'm gonna beat your ass.
Yeah.
She's like, Daddy, I can't do nothing. No, the fuck you cannot.
Yes.
Yeah.
You can't do shit.
Yeah.
You know, but I digress. I try to be.
But that's why you have all them girls.
Yeah, and I try to be. They made me a better fucking
come
man.
Back.
Yeah,
but it's a new world. You are correct.
Oh, it
like,
is.
You got. It's like you have to adapt to this new technology.
Uh-huh.
But this is what I'm saying about being in this new world. I said it before to this young brother. You got to be swift, changeable, but still remainable. I am me in any galaxy, in any planet, in any space and time.
In any
And I'm a blend in. Right. But the best part of this, I know you niggas is suckers.
Yeah.
You feel me? Somebody. So I'm going to blend in with you hoe ass niggas. Yeah. But when I catch you by yourself, I'm going to smack you like a big. Hey, when we're around people, don't you ever motherfucker.
Oh, say that Lord. To me. Mm-hmm. He always slapping some damn somebody. He's slapping somebody.
Somebody gonna get slapped.
Yeah, they gonna get slapped.
Look, I'm gonna tell you the most gross shit I ever did. Can I tell you one of the most gross shit I ever did? The teacher letters.
Please.
All right, when I was in prison, motherfucker, I used to be mad. Like, man, these niggas ain't send me no money or nothing, man. And then I see motherfuckers like, yeah, man, they getting money running court. That nigga getting money, no dirty ass bitch.
Yeah.
And I come home, niggas will spend me. Like, I got you. I was on Marv Vernon Avenue at the yellow cab sleeping in the motherfucking buses.
I know exactly what
for the whole week in my motherfucking state uniform, and all these niggas that used to fuck me spent them. And I remember what an old dope fiend said to me in prison. He said, listen, don't tell them nothing. When you go out there because they know you, when you rob them niggas, put your finger in their ass.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
And juke. I said what I said. He said, when you fight, he said, fight them niggas out their motherfucking clothes. And when you get them and they tied, you put your finger in their ass and juke it about 7 times until they cry.
That's the same finger from high school.
Yeah.
Okay. How does that make sense? I said, Russ,
why you want me to do some old weird ass shit like that? One. He said, because listen, for one, they lied to you, they disrespected you.
That's right.
And for two, they can never tell the police that you robbed them.
That's right.
He said, because a bitch ass nigga would say, yeah, he robbed me for his money. But he ain't gonna tell you that it's drug money. He gonna keep that part off.
Yeah.
And I see motherfuckers testify against niggas for robbing them. But they ain't gonna tell you that it was really because, nigga, you gave me, I came and get 7 grams. You gave me 5.3 grams, bitch. And I wanna smoke all my grams.
Yes. Uh-huh.
So if I gotta knock on your door, ho, give me my shit.
You can't be out here penetrating these motherfuckers.
I penetrated
it's not right.
A few niggas.
It's not right.
Then I see the day. And this is what I did. And then I juke the shit out of them. I know how a nigga butthole feel. But I ain't never suck a nigga dick in my life, and I ain't never did no homosexual shit in my life. I mean this shit, man. I've never did any homosexual shit in my life. But I juked it. That's not gay because I found no pleasure in it. I did it for the simple purpose is when I juke this nigga, he ain't gonna tell the police. And when I catch him on the block the next day, I walk up to him and say, hey, cuz, let me borrow $20. He goes like, yeah, Stink, I got you.
Because he love you now.
Nah, because he know if I catch him slipping, finger popping in the building, bitch.
You can take the check now.
I said what I said. And these niggas out here hearing this shit, and they know it's them. I know what the insides feel like.
Yeah.
Hilarious.
He all soft.
He a bitch.
Yeah. I mean, he got hurt, he got beat down.
I'm a comedian, but
he
I'm a
beat
down
up,
robbed,
and penetrated.
Hey, let me tell you something. Understand how to fight, you're gonna have.
You gotta go to your grandma's house, lay on the couch after some shit like that.
You lay on somebody's couch.
You just go,
and
just
you gotta
go
talk
lay,
about where you grew
lay
up.
Lay in the living room that you're not supposed to lay in. Yeah.
Listen, when I started doing trap houses and shit, right? Jesus. I'll be in the motherfucking room, breaking my shit up, bagging my shit up, right?
It'd be
a motherfucking there to go and beat a woman up and take her stem or take somebody else's stem, right?
Take her stem.
I go right down that motherfucker. I beat him up. I tie him up, put him in the tub, and put it on cold water until he got motherfucking Rumpelstiltskin skin, right? And then I say, bitch, don't you ever come in here and steal nothing from nobody motherfucking else, right? And then I take him out the motherfucking tub, and I sit him on the toilet, ass naked. I'm looking at his dick looking at me.
Oh,
I don't give
Lord.
A fuck. I grew up in prison. I seen many of his dicks.
Yeah.
You dig me?
That's nice.
I'm hearing what you said.
That's nice.
All gas. I hear what I'm talking about.
That's nice.
Uh-huh. All gas, no brakes.
I need to work.
Can I be in the motherfucking building without crashing?
I need to work at the
prison. So my motherfucking thing is...
they hiring?
Is you fucking bringing cigarettes in here?
I mean, I can.
I'm on sale block 27. Holla at me. All right.
I mean, I can. Yeah. Well, hell yeah.
He was going to finish the story. I want to hear the end of the story.
All right, what I was saying. All right, so listen. So after I finger pop these motherfuckers, I go up to him and I say, hey, bro, let me get $20. He going to give me $20. His homeboys, they bitches too. And they don't want to see me neither. They be like, man, why you get a nigga $20? I said, man, I fuck with Stink. I fuck with that nigga Stink. Really, you know, you disrespecting me, bitch.
Yeah.
When I came home from prison, you should have did what you said you was going to do for me.
They never do.
But I'm going to make them.
That's how you find out who they are.
In life, you got to teach people how to love.
Love you, yes. Mm.
Just because you,
doing.
My mother and my father used to beat my ass, and now that I'm an adult, I felt myself. You got to talk to me different.
Yeah.
That's
It's up to me now.
You can't say, I'm going to leave all this shit to my kids, penthouses and mansions. They might just want a studio apartment and be at peace.
Yeah. Right.
You can't force your shit on other people. You got to love people the way they want to be loved.
That's it. Yeah.
Or you via fucking lady them, like putting your fingers in the nigga ass.
That's right.
Back to the
I've been doing that, though, just to check them.
Oh, Jesus.
I mean, I've been doing that just to check them, make sure they, you know, tender and shit.
And they fall.
Yeah, because one time this nigga gave me some pussy, and I know, I remember that shit.
He gave you some pussy?
Yes, I said, nigga, this is not no fucking dick. I know this ain't the dick you was talking. This ain't the shit you was talking about giving me, is it?
Hey, shut the fuck up.
This nigga gave me some pussy.
How the nigga gonna get you?
I swear to God, I ain't lying. You know I ain't lying.
Was it good pussy?
It was good pussy.
Oh, yes. No breaks in this bitch.
Nothing like some good pussy.
Nothing like it.
But listen, niggas ain't mad good. When Biggie said, man, the pussy's so good, I'll suck your father's
That's
dick.
That's right.
Niggas weren't mad. He said, Younger, I fucked the shit out of this motherfucking girl.
Yeah.
Like, I would have hugged her daddy. Like, nigga, did you know what the fuck?
I don't see that part.
That's one of the plots.
They jumped the fence.
That's no pussy that
And girl. Niggas was singing it with their whole hearts. Suck him out sucking a dick.
Hilarious.
I ain't never physically suck a dick. And never
not
will.
Physically. Have you
never
physically?
No, I never. I'm a lesbian.
I never physically
I'm just saying.
A dick.
I've never had a nigga dick in my hand.
In my
well,
mind.
I did have a nigga dick in my hand. Because I'll check a nigga.
Right.
Like if a nigga says some gay shit, I'll grab my dick. Say, what's up, yeah. You bitch ass nigga? What you trying to do?
Shake his dick.
Let me check a nigga dick.
Brother, let me
That's
ask
right.
you, let me ask
That's
you
right.
one more question, yeah. sir. And we're going to roll out of here. Guys.
Was I wrong with
you? No, you're wrong. You're right, baby. I'm right here with you.
Nobody.
I'm right here with you.
I check a nigga for his shit.
I'm trying to tell you.
Oh, you want to play soft, nigga? Let me grab your dick, you little bitch.
I put it right in his ass.
Don't check with
me. Not me.
Yo, what can you offer us that someone cannot? What you watched our show, you seen what we've been doing, and if you could offer something about our show that we can do best, what can you offer us? Because all you propelling with and what you're doing, your comedy's dope. I dig it.
Very dope.
I offer you loyalty. I offer you genuine comedy. I offer you good energy.
Mm-hmm. So that's what we should be putting back out as well.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, when you fuck with Mr. Dark Comedy, you get the truth.
Yeah. Yes.
At all points and all levels.
Yes.
Ain't no shame in experience. Yes. You know what I'm saying? And I live by that shit. I stamp that shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And that's what makes me be me. When you fuck with me, you know that you're getting original.
It's a whole vibe.
It is a whole vibe. By my motherfucking self.
Yes.
And I got to say that I can wipe my own ass, meaning I don't need a motherfucker for shit.
Yeah. Word.
Right?
Yeah.
But that don't mean I don't want a motherfucker.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
I want my own
motherfucking person in the middle of the motherfucking night. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's so bullshit. Like, I go out here and be like, I'm fucking, what's up? You know? Yeah. She's like, I'm about to get in the car and go to the gas station right now. Come here and fuck me, Shorty. But, you know, I would rather have a woman that loves me and knows Sandy.
Mm-hmm.
Fuck Mr. Dark Comedy. Fuck all these other other things, people that I create. I gotta right now, I have a character called Blackface the Comedy. Blackface the Comedian. And Blackface, I dress up in a comedy outfit and shit. And I do a lot of shit.
You doing costumes now.
Yeah. I entertain. I'm an entertainer.
What kind of costumes you do?
I look like a ghost of New Orleans.
Oh, I can see that.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
I can definitely see that.
Real deep. You know what I'm saying? Real deep.
Wow.
Saying,
wow.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So I got all these different characters inside of me, and I like to play them.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I like to bring them to life.
Okay. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And, you know, like right now in my life, it's just me finding the right energies to come along with me so that I can make it happen. Like, you got LeBron, but, you know, it's all about people that's around LeBron that made LeBron. Right? So without those people that made LeBron, you won't have LeBron. You got Jordan, but you can't forget Scottie Pippen.
Shit, mm-hmm. not at all.
You know what I'm saying? So, so no matter how great that are, whatever, because I'm going to sell Mr. Dark Comedy out at the end of the day. I'm going to be the first to tell you. Because when it comes to the power to be and all this Illuminati in a nigga ass and all that shit, I'll kill off Dark Comedy, put a costume on them, and I'll sell them to the powers that be.
Yeah, yeah.
Because anybody can get in the mask and say some gangster shit. Mm-hmm. But I live this shit at the end of the day.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
That's absolutely correct.
You know, I feel like I'm going to be as great as my mistakes.
Hey, I like that.
You know what I'm saying?
I like that.
I made some hella fire mistakes, man. Consciously and subconsciously. But I'm going to be as great as any mistake I've ever made.
For real.
That's dope.
That is dope.
I like that. That is dope. Yo, thank you, man, for coming on the show.
I've been having this motherfucker told me to run about.
Yeah, we had you this motherfucker talking, son.
But he has snacks. He has snacks.
As long as they have snacks.
Shout out to my boy Rex Corona.
Hey, the one and only. The one and only.
The one and only.
Cool ass motherfucker.
Had bourbon. You were like, yo, this Jim Beam. Yes. Got the apple and shit.
And he got his man in the background in the corner and
that's
shit.
His brother, that's dog. His brother, dog.
Man, you
that's
can tell because they vibing hard over there.
They both got the just same lead. Like,
yeah.
I feel like if I say something to one of them, both of them going to whoop my ass.
That's it.
So I ain't going to fuck both of them at the same time. Jump me, nigga. I'm tired.
Yeah.
I'm sleepy anyway. Man. See, you knocked me out. No, you didn't knock me out. I was sleepy. You hit me, and I was.
Yo, look, it's so funny you bring that up because we talk about family and family riding with each other. Yeah. I want to shout out to my boy Rex, man. This man always, every time I see him, he got family and family.
He's
and with
a family
him.
Man.
And I love so, that shit. Yeah. Like, from him, I take that shit. Yeah. So.
Anybody ever tell you, like, Benny Siegel?
I've never heard that one. I've heard Rick Ross. I've heard.
No.
Somebody, not Rick.
You look like Benny Siegel. Somebody told me that before. I
love Benny Siegel, dog. Benny Siegel was like my time.
The dog's barking.
The dog is barking. Yo, first time.
He had a DMX joint.
I'm wrapping it up now. Y'all first know the
He had the DMX joint.
All right, come on. I'm ready.
Yeah. All right.
All gas, no brakes.
All right, y'all have a great day. Yeah.
The shit bark, son. Yo, on the bark, baby.
What the fuck is that?
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm right. A wolf and all dogs come to me,
picked
man.
Up the motherfucking phone.
Quanta, thank you.
I knew them niggas had to be kid. Fuck your couch, nigga. I knew it, because the vibe is so strong. I'm going to tell you come from y'all two, brother.
They got the same leave.
They
got the same leave.
They got the Al Bundy leave.
They like drunk, but they can go to school anyway.
They just go to school.
Right. Like, listen. Like,
yo, what grade are they in? What grade are they in?
Ninth grade. Ninth grade off the top. They freshmen. They the coolest freshmen in the building.
Come on, they ain't gonna drop out of school. Y'all just got into the school with the coolness.
Yeah, they came to school running shit. Look, me and my brother gonna be upstairs and beat lunch.
They taking lunch.
That's what it's gonna be.
Yeah.
Taking the whole second lunch.
Hey, listen, all gas, no brakes. I give you all love,
thank
Rex.
You, thank you.
Good looking out. Big good bro. Looking out.
You know what I'm saying? Young absolutely. Star. Thank you know what I'm talking about?
Yo, where can we find you at? Where can we find you?
Y'all
at?
Got my phone number. Call me, nigga.
I'm going to call you, too.
Instagram, Facebook, everywhere, man. But, you know, that's small shit. You know what I'm saying? Word. I'm working on a big motherfucking scale.
Okay.
I'm looking for everybody to fucking know my name. You know what I'm saying? And I ain't going to stop until they do. You feel me?
For real.
That's it.
Where can we find you at, my brother to my left?
You can find me at VVICTH.
VVITCH.
Nice. Like long shit.
I've been saying that shit for so long.
Yeah, y'all live.
VVI.
You did it.
No, he does not.
He got us wrong.
No,
I get messed up. I get messed up with the V's.
He got juice in that motherfucker, dog. Juice.
VVITCHES__ We got it. We got it.
It's on tape, so they can't
find Quan, where can they find, where can they find you at, miss?
I'm Quan Duval, and I'm everywhere.
She's everywhere, too.
I'm everywhere.
I'm at Super Saiyan Santi. Hey. You follow us at AGNB Podcast. We donate here. We got the link going to be down here. Donate. We got to get Rex more dope-ass equipment. Please, guys, get Rex more dope-ass equipment.
He dope as fuck now.
The dopest motherfucker on
now. We're going to get doper.
Shout out to my boy at Rex Corollis.
That's right.
He's over there to the left over there chilling, man. Shout out to everybody. All gas, no brakes, man. Thank you.
Hey,
man.
I love you. Love y'all.
And then the leader ran up on me. I knew he was the leader because he was the only motherfucker with sundress and jelly bean slippers on this shit. So he ran up on me and said, nigga, give me all your shit. I was like, damn. Oh, he didn't take this because she looking at me in the back with me hungry and shit. You getting robbed. She act like you the reason we getting robbed. Like, I can't stop these motherfuckers robbing this shit. So I'm taking my shit. Pat me down and shit. Taking my wallet, doing on the ground, all that stuff. Patting on my dick and shit. And I was like, man, get the fuck off me. Because of other projects, I was like this shit like that. But then, his second in command, I knew he was the second in command. Because he the only motherfucker that had a leather skirt set on, and they had a ring. So he's like, let a motherfucking real nigga touch your dick. He packing that. I'm under pressure like a motherfucker, because dicks are stupid. You know, I can bump to the pole, boom, dick hard as a motherfucker for that. So I'm under pressure, because he packed my dick, you know, and they got guns on me. So only thing I can do is pray. I'm like, Lord, please don't let my dick get hard. They're aggressive. Like, I can tell they did it before, because the niggas in the background like, get him, get him. Like, listen, first of all, let me say this. If you're a black man in America and you comfortable wearing wigs and dresses, you dangerous. They gonna kill some shit. You gonna put on a dress, nigga, you dangerous. So I can't do shit. So you pat me down, so you're like, God, please. So I had to get deep into prayer. I said, Lord, as you help Zachariah, Meshach, and the baby goat, please help me. And I felt the tingle and shit. It started to get hard. And now my heart started out wanting to shit. But I started feeling the buzz. And he started getting fast with the shit. And I'm just moving. And I'm looking over at this bitch like, is she going to say something about shit like this? Like this. So I fucking got snitched on her. Man, she got money too. So, and listen, I don't think they do like women sometimes. Like, especially black women, they like to act like them, but they don't want to be in the gym. So they get in the rings, boom, shut up, this is person. And shut up. And this is what I like about a dumb motherfucker. I snitched on her. Well, that dumb ass over like, Sandy, help me, help me. This is I'm not gonna help you. We're over here with Millie Vanilli was molesting me over this motherfucking shit. So shit was crazy. But look, listen. So I didn't know how to act to this shit, but she was taking it tough. They gave us our shit back and left off. I think a dick is all they wanted me to do. They just wanted to rubble a motherfucking dick. Let a real nigga rub the dick sometimes. I said, fuck. Rapping is changing. When we get to the fucking rap change, though, we get the house like, fucked up. I know you upset about what happened to you, but don't worry about it. I'm gonna suck this shit out to you. You gonna forget all about what the fuck happened. She said it, I felt comfortable about it. We gonna do this shit. Now, she tried to slap my dick in half. It was so wet, my thighs was wet, my butt. Have you ever swim in a pool full of jellyfish? Cause that's what the fuck it felt like. Like I never knew she had that much fucking water in her mouth. And so she doing this shit, and while she was doing this shit, I felt a finger swipe past my butthole. I didn't want to stop the move or nothing, so I just tighten my butt up, just kept going with this shit. Like, goddamn, I said a movie for the fucking jellyfish. Have you sprinted? Then you gonna shut the fuck up too. So I said, like, yeah, maybe she been doing something, being aggressive and shit. And about the second time, I said, hold on, bitch, you're not gonna change me up in this motherfucker. She said, shut the fuck up. Tell me when you're about to come. I'm gonna put my fingers in your ass, and you come harder than you ever came in your life. 2018. Listen, I let her do the shit right, but listen. I don't know if you don't touch me. I said one time, I almost passed the fuck out. And I'm fat too, so you know how that feels. Because he gave me options. Listen, you can either lay down all the way on your side, or sit back here with your legs wide. Where they got my motherfucking paint on the ceiling of the motherfucking apartment is beautiful. I put my legs over, so I can't hold the shit, it's just changed. But the date has changed. You don't know what a woman wants. You don't know what the fuck she been through. They be like, yeah, I want you to choke me. Bitch, I'm not going to jail for this shit. You know what I'm saying? And then they complain, like, I don't want no short man, no fat man. Well, most of you bitches got ugly pussies. Let me say that. You know what I'm saying? She always come almost in here. I was in here too, bitch. But she got all this skin on her pussy every time I stop it going in her mouth. You know, I mean, it's a pussy, but listen, it's a hell of a hell, bitch. I'm trying to kill a motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? So she's like, fuck you, nigga, you uncircumcised. I said, wait a minute, bitch. It's the drop top. Pull the skin back. Fuck you. It's for security purposes. You know what I'm saying? She like this. Nigga, I'm gonna get carpal tunnel syndrome, jacking your dick off and shit. Bitch, you better have plenty about the good job. You understand? I'm Mr. Dark Comedy. Welcome to the Dark Style of Comedy, y'all.
Yeah. Oh, before we go, shit.
What?
We ain't even gonna talk about Dave Chappelle.
We kind of
started with it.
We kind of did.
Yeah. We started with it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This nigga.
Play the tape back.
This is going to be at the end of the video. This shit right here, dog.
Play the tape back.
I wanted to hear what y'all had to say.
Well, you got to listen to the motherfucking podcast, motherfucker.
You watch it. I watch it. I finish watching. Watch it again.
Right?
You got tears in my eyes,
oh, my God. Yo, I'm keeping this. This is no bullshit. This is a great show.
I got a picture of it.
Oh, yeah, man. Let's do that shit.